St. John, this is Tucker. I haven't seen Mr. Sweetface around these last years. I'm sure he's all right.
Loser's fine. Like I said, he's just been busy.
Doing runs for that son of a bitch Mark Copeland, no doubt. I have a feeling he doesn't like me much.
Like I said, this old lady. Right, I gotta finish burning out these nests. Don't worry, fellas, I'll be back later. Finish burning you out. Should be it. God damn it.
Hope you got something for us, Tristan. I used to be a cop.
Hey, Cope. I think Leon was bringing you this.
Oh, Deke. You made a wise choice. Wise choice. You go see Manny. Maybe he can help you with that bike of yours.
Cope says you've been helping out. Out around the camp. He won't say it, but he appreciates it.
Manny. Loser, where the hell aren't you in your damn bunk?
I couldn't sleep. Remember what I said back in the tunnel? Don't go up there, Dave. It's making you crazy.
Loser,
I go up there because there's freaks up there. I kill them here, I kill them there. Bounties are all the same to me.
Then what are the tulips for, huh? I saw them, Deke. Here on the table. This morning. The same one she had at the wedding. I remember.
I'm not gonna... Listen, Boozer, get some rest. I gotta go. Deacon out.
And then the tulips, Boozer, they're stone crop. Get it right. Hey, Cope, this man I'm tracking down, who'd he kill?
Why do you care? It's just another bounty job, isn't it?
Now, look, I don't care. I just want to know their names. Who, Cope?
One of them is a man named Randall. Been with the camp almost a year. I didn't know the other two. You want me to ask?
No, I guess not.
You find that son of a bitch, you radio me. Copeland out.
Okay, let's see. What's going on here? Still got...
There he is! Silver helmet. Red gas tank. That's him.
Hey, asshole! Stop the damn bike!
The hell?
So you thought you'd ride into Copeland's camp, shoot the place up, then? All right. Kill a few folks, take some shit, and just ride out like you just... chop at them all.
Copeland sent you? Tell him to go to hell!
Myself, if you want to know the truth, give drifters a bad name. What if you'd shot Manny? You know, who'd fix my bike then? Stupid piece of shit.
Screw you! You are Copeland's toadies! You little bitch! That's what you are! You little bitch!
Doesn't look too bad. That should do it. Boozer, you there? I was just calling to check up on you.
Yeah, Dean, come here.
You hang in there, buddy. As soon as we get that arm patched up, we'll ride north, just like you said.
I hope so. God, I miss you.
Just work on getting better. I still got some work to do on the bike, and we gotta stock up on some gear. But once you're patched up, we're out of here. Deacon out.
Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. This earth is a gift for us all, to use as we see fit, to provide for ourselves and our families. I'm not saying this. It's the Lord that gave us dominion over it. But that wasn't enough for some men. They wanted more. When our fuel got low, they jacked up the prices so they could consolidate power into their own hands. So, we wanted to build dams for electricity. But their precious runs of salmon were more important than heating our homes. We wanted to cut a few trees to build those homes. But the nests of a few spotted owls were more important than the entire timber industry. Now that the feds have gone to ground, let's just say we've eliminated the middleman. No one can stop us from taking what's rightfully ours. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Thing is, Cope, fuel prices have come down lately. Way down. Only problem is you gotta find it yourself. And last I checked, there were plenty of assholes out here trying to take what's rightfully ours. Okay, let me guess. Out of fuel. Yeah, of course. Here. You got that? You feed me to the hand. Not out here. This kid is mine. How many of you sons? sons of bitches, are there?
Huh? Any of you left? How many?
This. That'll hold. That's the last of them. Hey, babe. Yeah, I cleaned them out. They won't be bothering you no more. Hey, me again.
I'm gonna tell you something.
Hey, it's okay. It's just my arm.
You told me that we shouldn't come back, and I didn't listen to you. I mean, I knew that it was getting worse, but I...
None of us knew it was going to blow up like this. Listen, this fast.
You don't understand. I don't know what I would do if I lost you. This is my fault.
Hey. I'm losing anyone. I made a promise. Remember?
Deacon, wait!
Sarah, come on.
There's a kid here. Hey. Hey, are you okay? Come on, we gotta find your parents, okay?
There you go.
Come on. Oh, she stabbed me. I don't think it's that bad.
Okay, what?
Okay.
Just hold this here as long as you can.
I don't think so. I think I can walk.
Okay, good enough. Almost there.
Okay.
2 hours ago, this place was calling the feds.
Yeah, they must have evacuated.
Yeah. They must have bugged out. Yeah, she's burning up. The knife must have nicked her kidney or something. She's turning septic. There you go, little sister.
So stupid. It was this little kid. This goddamn little kid.
Big goddamn knife.
Hey, help me.
Shit.
Your mom. You want to be when we come through?
We gotta get to the roof, flag down one of those choppers.
All right. See if you can rest over here.
Hey, easy, easy.
She reminded me so much of my little sister, you know. Because we used to play that hide-and-seek game all the time. And she would just hide her head in her coat just like that.
I've been cutting my name, but nothing like that.
She's burning up.
Jesus. Okay.
We gotta move. We ain't going that way. Come on. All right. Hey, swim here. Can you move? Closer.
Yeah, I got her. Go find us a way out.
Okay. Everyone, hold on. Hold on. Easy. Okay, you get his attention. I'll try to sneak up behind him, okay?
It's nothing, Coco. I got this, go!
Hold on, don't. Yeah, we see you got guns,
got
shoot.
Stop shooting! Sir? Hey! I'm unarmed!
Get out!
Now listen to me! My girl's out there. She's been stabbed. We're just trying to get to the roof.
You're right.
There's a helicopter.
You killed her.
So listen.
You killed my wife.
Oh no. Look, I didn't know anything about your wife being killed. I am sorry, sir. What are you doing?
You killed her. You killed my wife.
Stop.
Wait, we need help. She's been wounded.
What's wrong with her?
Well, she's not. Whatever the hell's going on out there, she's been stabbed.
I can't take anymore.
Oh, okay. Listen, O'Brien. If we don't get her to a hospital, she's going to die.
There are no more hospitals.
Oh, come on. No more hospitals. You got doctors, you got triage, you got a mass unit.
Oh, look, I'm just a grad student, okay? I got volunteers for this. I'm not even supposed to be out here, okay?
O'Brien.
Okay. I've only got room for two of you, okay? Two.
You got room for two of
you? You're overweight, okay? I can only take two of you. Two.
Okay. Come on, help me. Come on. All right, sweetheart.
okay. You're gonna be all right.
I got her.
I'm gonna be right back. Okay, Boozer, let's go. We gotta get on that chopper.
I heard what he said. There's only room for two on that chopper. Go. Go with her. I'll be okay. Look, I've been through worse shit than this before. You know?
Here we go.
Where are you going?
What?
Where?
Refugee camp, west of Three Finger Jack.
No.
Boozer is never gonna make it without me. I want this back.
You coming?
Check on you, and I know, yeah, you wouldn't want me to, but I guess Boozer's right. I can't help myself. It's like I said, I'll be back.